Hi guys, and welcome to my presentation for Reading as Other. This is Jennifer Tizard, and I'm going to present on the book Last Stop on Market Street. But first I want to tell you about Reading as Other. Books should allow readers to see a new world, see from someone else's perspective, see themselves, gain empathy for people who are different from them, and notice the similarities they have to diverse people. Now, Last Stop on Market Street. It's written by Matt De La Pena, and the illustrations are by Christian Robinson. It was published in 2015 by G.P. Putnam's Sons. About Matt De La Pena. Matt wrote several critically acclaimed and award-winning books. He teaches creative writing and lives in Brooklyn, New York. For more information, visit him at www.mattdelapena.com at Matt De La Pena. About Christian Robinson. He grew up riding the bus with his Nana, just like CJ, the boy in the book. He lives in San Francisco. You can visit him at www.theartoffun.com. So about the book. The Last Stop on Market Street follows CJ and his Nana as they travel through the city. Nana changes CJ's focus as they move along. At the same time, she changes our perspective. CJ asks questions and Nana answers them. He asks, why do we have to be standing in the rain waiting for the bus? Why don't we have a car? Why is this part of the city dirty? She answers these questions in very fair, honest, and focus-changing ways. She tells him that it doesn't matter that they don't have a car because they can ride the bus. She tells him that the rain is needed for the trees, and she tells him that if you just look down, you'll only see the dirt, but if you look up, there's a rainbow. My favorite part of the book is where CJ learns how to listen to music from a blind man. While they're on the bus, CJ sees these two boys walk in, and they have an MP3 player. He wants one. Nana asks why. Because we have somebody who can play music right in front of us. And the blind friend that she has sitting with her says, and I listen by closing my eyes. I can see the world that way. Listen to this part. And in darkness, the rhythm lifted CJ out of the bus, out of the busy city. He saw sunset colors swirling over crashing waves. Saw a family of hawks sliding through the sky. Saw the old woman's butterflies dancing free in the light of the moon. CJ's chest grew full and he was lost in the sound. And the sound gave him the feeling of magic. In the end, CJ and his grandma go to a soup kitchen and meet their friends so that they can serve others. Look at the happy face that CJ and his grandma have from serving others. His focus has been changed. Put a little love in your heart. This is a fitting song by Jackie DeShannon. Check out this video. Now for the challenge. I decided to add a challenge to the end of my video. Louis Sachar wrote a series of books called Marvin Redpost. This one is Marvin Redpost, Is He a Girl? Look up Marvin Redpost, Is He a Girl? And try to find a summary or something about it. Or you can read it I don't know if you want to, but you can at least look up a summary about it. After you're done, comment on my post what you think. Does this book, Marvin Redpost, is he a girl, fit this week's posts? Why or why not? Thank you for watching my video, and I appreciate you taking the time.